Welcome to the ISTL wrap-up for Season 3. My name is Shalthus from the GKick Network at gkick.net, and it's playoff time. This week, we'll be giving you all of the action from this past week's wild card and Round of 8 action. As the season draws to a head, let's take a look at which teams will be competing starting next Sunday in the Round of 4, leading into Championship Sunday on October 28th. In the wild card, our first matchup would pit Impulse Esports up against Team Fallacy. Impulse would send the Zerg player Psycho out against the Protoss Moa from Fallacy to start things off. In utter dominating fashion, Psycho would clear out the Protoss roster of Fallacy, including Ska and Cardress, before eliminating Slurpee in Game 4 to complete the all-kill just shy of the 20-minute mark and eliminate Fallacy from the ISTL playoffs. In the second wildcard match, Team Optic would take on Ripsies. In Game 1, the Zerg player Optic Scary would take on the Protoss Z's Vogue. Scary would force the GG in Game 1 before also taking out the Terran player Z's Jimmy in Game 2. Scary's run would end in Game 3 as the Protoss Z's Zugs would claim the first win for his team and proceed to tie the series up at 2 games each against the Protoss Optic Riddles. The Zerg Optic Coyote would take the win in Game 5 and manage to seal the series out in Game 6 by defeating the Terran player Z's JJH and eliminating Ripsies from the playoffs. So, with the wildcard games decided and the Round of 8 full, we headed straight into quarterfinal action. The first Round of 8 matchups would put Western Wolves up against Team Alt. In Game 1, the Terran Fargo from Western Wolves would take on the Protoss player Bonk from Team Alt. Fargo would take Game 1, but would fall to the Zerg player Alt Dice in Game 2. Western Wolves would send out the Protoss player Starnan, who would eliminate Dice in Game 3, and also the Zerg player Alt IMYT in Game 4. In Game 5, the Terran Alt Bad Cop would come out in a long TVP, which despite his best efforts would ultimately fall in favor of Starnan and Western Wolves to seal the series and advance the defending champions to the Round of 4. In what may be the best series of the playoffs so far, Impulse Esports would take on Team Property. Opening things off would be the Zerg player Imp Regret up against the Zerg Prop Blixt. Regret would take Game 1, drop the next game to the Terran Bobson, who himself would fall to the Protoss player Niter from Impulse. The trading would continue as the Protoss player Snuffy would even the series for Property and even eliminate Impulse's Terran player Ender to put Property one win away from taking the series. The Zerg player Shield would come out in a crazy Game 6. Snuffy's attempt to end early almost paid off, but some clever Spinecrawler placement held him off and put him far enough behind economically, but it would linger on to nearly 20 minutes to tie the series up and force a Game 7. The Terran, Gillian, would come out next, and it wouldn't take much as some devastating mech play would award the game to Property and move them on to the semis. In an abrupt turnaround, the next Round of 8 match would pit Team Optic against the undefeated My Intent. The Zerg Optic Coyote would start things off against the Protoss MYI Fiery, and things would look very, very familiar as Fiery would take Coyote down by taking out his economy. Amazingly, due to roster issues, Optic would have to forfeit their quarterfinal matchup after only one game, allowing My Intent to advance to the Round of 4 practically uncontested. Last but not least, Inferno DTG would take on Team Classic to decide who would move on to that last semi-final spot. The Protoss Sickness from Inferno DTG would head out first against the Zerg Moosekills for Classic, and DTG would be off to a good start with the early win. The Zerg Mav would head out next to even the series up before taking out the Protoss player Gandalf. DTG would send out his Protoss player Scar, but it would still not be enough as Mav would head into Game 5 against the Protoss player Madcow. And while it would look extremely close and roll into the late game, Mav would come in and complete the all-kill to eliminate DTG and secure his team's place in the Round of 4. So with those matches decided, we'll have Team Property taking on Classic next Sunday, followed by Championship Sunday the week after, which will include a Season 2 Finals rematch as Western Wolves take on My Intent in the Round of 4, followed by the third place match and the Grand Finals themselves. Don't forget to catch it all live at twitch.tv/impulse, follow the ISTL on Twitter at imp_esports, subscribe to this channel for all the latest ISTL wrap-ups, and visit the ISTL online at impulseesports.com. This has been Shalthus, and we'll see you next time for the final wrap-up of Season 3.